It's good seeing you, man. So, okay, I just want to go back, right? So I remember when we first met in that meeting in Fox, and you know, one of the things that struck me was just, you know, your humility. And just like, I'm like, wait, has that always been, you know, your approach, or is that just natural?
It's always been my approach. I had been blessed with great parents, obviously, that kind of set me on my way early. We could never get too big-headed about anything.
Right.
I grew up, obviously, my dad played professional basketball for 16 years, so I was around kind of the life that I live now and in the industry that he was in. So I learned from him how he handled, you know, fan interaction, how he was a professional in every way, shape, or form of how he carried himself, and that rubbed off on me and my siblings well. And I've tried not to stray too far from that in terms of no matter what happens in life, I try to stay as even keel as possible, knowing everything is a blessing. Everything that I do, there's no accidents in life. But I'm you know, in this position because you know, I've been blessed with talents and the perspective that I'd be able to handle all of this, you know, the success and the failure. So they set me on my way for sure.
Got it. Clearly they did, because, you know, having known of you but not knowing you when we had that meeting, it was like, wow, you know, bringing that humility when you're one of the most recognizable people in the world, but you don't wear that, you know. And I've been in Hollywood for 20 years, so most people who have done a fraction of what you do wear that. So I thought that was pretty amazing. Well, when did you get the idea of, like, I want to move into entertainment, I want to start making films? What transpired and what gave you that idea to say, you know what, now's the time to do it?
I mean, the genesis of pretty much anything I do is to try to inspire and find different ways to reach the masses, to use the platform that I have to kind of, you know, share the core values of who I am as a person. And so when the idea and the kind of approach that we wanted to have in terms of the media space and getting into film, we wanted to do it the right way, stay true and authentic to who I am and what I stand for, and find projects that I really believed in and could get behind, not just as, you know, a face or just because, but there's a reason and a mission and a perspective behind it. And so obviously you're only good as the people that you put around you. And I have a great team that has kind of helped me get that far.
One of the best teams going.
For sure.
I know you know it,
that's
but I'm just letting
it
you know.
Happens. That's kind of how I approach on and off the court.
In terms of
obviously I want to bring something to the table and from a leadership perspective. But again, you're only as good as the people are around you. You being able to grow together and go through different experiences. And obviously you fall in that basket as well. So, you know, it's all about inspiring. And hopefully anything that I touch that has, you know, my name on it or something attached to it, that they know what it stands for.
Yeah, I mean, literally, I think that's one of the reasons why we're aligned, because that's why I'm in entertainment, you know, because I do believe entertainment is one of the most powerful mediums in the world. And if we can use it for good, the change that can happen in the world, you know, is just exponential. So going back, so I sent you the script, right? So what happened when you cracked it open and you started reading it? What was your experience reading this script?
To be honest with you, this is probably one of the first scripts I've read in its entirety in terms
of,
like, you kind of, I guess when you read them, you know kind of the flow, you kind of get a feeling, you know, at first glance kind of look. But my team would tell you, when I sat down and read it for one sitting, read it all the way through.
You read the script in one sitting?
And that speaks to, obviously, the impact that this movie's gonna have for everybody who watches it, in terms of, I was reading these words on a piece of paper and I could visualize the journey of each character, knowing what John went through and the people, the community that was around him, how they were affected positively in terms of you know, just being touched and finding faith and finding things to believe in and whatnot. And it was a cool experience for me to follow the journey in script form, knowing where this could go as a project.
Right. So in sending you the script and you reading it in the first sitting, what kept you turning the pages about this story?
Mostly was John's mom's faith, first and foremost, how bold she was in terms of, obviously, when she goes to the hospital and here's basically all the bad news that's being sent to her about the prognosis of her son's chance of living. She wasn't taking no for an answer because of her belief in God and knowing that you know, he can do miracles and he can do powerful things. I was really drawn to that. I have a very strong mom as well who mm-hmm. instilled my faith in me, mm-hmm. so I could kind of connect to that as well.
My mom did the same thing with the belt, though.
Trust me, there was a little bit of that. A little bit of that.
I know that's not PC these days, but
there's a lot
she's
of
like, you're going to get this faith in you.
I got a lot of that, a lot of prayer. My kind of fun stories are growing up, I'd be asleep in my room probably between like 10 and 12, 13 mm-hmm. years old. And you'd wake up to a hand on your forehead, and I'd hear whispering, and my mom was praying over me in my sleep.
Wow.
And like, when you have that happen, you don't know whether to wake up or like to
just act say like anything. You're still asleep.
I know what's going on, so I'm just gonna, you know, stay quiet, stay still, and,
right.
and understand what she's praying over my future and over wow. my well-being. But like, in terms of having a bold mom that. That kind of instilled that faith in me,
sure.
For and planted the seed.
Yeah.
Obviously, I had to find that out for myself, but I could connect with that, you know, extremely well. And yeah, it was just a powerful testimony to faith.
Yeah.
To be honest, and that's something that that I gravitated towards.
And so, you gravitated towards it. You put it down, and then you were like, okay, I'm in. I want to do this.
It took one phone call with my team, and they asked me, hey, how'd you like the script? And I'm pretty sure they were shocked at how excited I was about it. But yeah, try to find a way to latch on mm-hmm. And hopefully, you know.
Not latch on, man.
You know what I mean.
Partner up. Yeah.
Partner up, yes.
yeah.
And find ways to, again, help use this story to inspire.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, listen, when I got the call, I was like, what? Are you serious?
It was cool because it was on the heels of our meeting at Fox.
Yeah.
And so I could tell by your energy and any project that you get behind, there's got to be a good reason for it.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And that, we didn't talk about it before I read the mm-hmm. script or anything, but in terms of like knowing who was behind, you know, the project and understanding full integrity in terms of bringing this to life, that was, I could get behind that.
Appreciate that, man. Yeah, definitely. I mean, what spoke to me was your desire to do faith, your desire to do sports, and your desire to do family.
Mm-hmm.
And literally after that meeting, I'm like, well, I'm getting ready to make breakthrough. What do you think, man? And speaking of teams, because you've mentioned it, you know, quite a bit, in the story, it, even though it was Joyce's prayer that, you know, started, was the catalyst for John's recovery, it did take a team. You know, it took the pastor, it took the firefighters, it took the community, you know, praying around John
mm-hmm.
and really rallying around his success. Why is teamwork so important to you? Because in your life, especially also your profession, you seem to value that almost more than what's good for you. It seems like you're asking what's good for the team. Why is teamwork so important to you?
It's something that I've always just appreciated in terms of, it's not always about me. It never really is about me. Mm-hmm. It's about, mm-hmm. obviously, I know what I'm capable of and what I can bring to the table, but again, nothing that you do in life, you do alone. Nothing sure. successful you do, I should say.
That's true.
Having an appreciation for the value in others, mm-hmm. I can learn something from the person next to me, on my right or my left. They can challenge me, the sense of accountability.
Mm-hmm.
It's how you grow. And for me, that's where you really make memories
yeah.
in terms of, I could do all this stuff by myself. If I have nobody to share it with and nobody to kind of go back and say, hey, look what we did, I don't think there's any value in that. And
yeah.
so I've always had that perspective from middle playing AAU baseball and basketball
yeah.
All the way through now in the NBA, really understanding that there's so much good in the collective.
Sure.
And I value everybody that's a part of that equation to achieve success and achieve great things, because again, when you come together and you have a collective goal in mind, that journey is the best part about it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the part you talk yeah. about. You don't even talk about, hey, remember when we were on the podium and we were holding that trophy? It's like, nah, remember all that work we put in the off
totally.
Season? Remember the five games we lost in a row and we had a players only meeting, we talked about it, we figured out how to get through it. The ups and downs, all mm-hmm. that's the part that I really, that's the stuff that you remember the most. And so for me, it's always been, I haven't had a hard time sacrificing for that.
Right. Well, some do. So it's definitely unique. And I think it's fascinating that, you know, your own personal belief in teamwork is mirrored so closely, you know, in the film. And that's also kind of what inspired, you know, for me to want to say, hey, Steph, let's do this. because I do believe it's about team. I do believe, especially in this space, when it's about, you know, how do we get inspiration to the world? Mm-hmm. You know, we're stronger together than we are apart. And so I felt like on a film like this, you know, building a strong team, you know, between ourselves and our director, Roxann, our other executive producers, Pastor Sam Rodriguez and Chrissy and Topher and the whole cast, like, you know, let's stack the deck, you know, for as much success as we can so we can get a breakthrough.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
I like that.
Speaking of breakthroughs, like, okay, so the movie's breakthrough, right? Yeah. So this is, I'm curious to see how you respond to this and what this feels like. There are a lot of people, you know, that may see this that are struggling in life and trying to go from where they are to, you know, where they want to be. Recently, you had a breakthrough performance on the court, 51 points, you know, I mean, you know all the stats. What does it take to produce a breakthrough? And how does it feel when you're in that moment? How much is in your control or out of your control?
Man, it takes patience, and it takes a commitment to whatever the disciplines. And so for me, you talk about that game, 51 points, everything's clicking. Only thing I can think about in that moment, one, this is so much fun. Like, I'm gonna yeah, enjoy this, but more so in that moment, I think about the random Wednesday morning at 6:30 a.m. that I was running on a treadmill and threw up because I was exhausted and pushing myself to a limit that I really didn't know. It's all about just the patience and the discipline to stay the course, mm-hmm, to have faith and belief in yourself, mm-hmm, that eventually something's gonna happen, a door's gonna open, you're gonna be, mm-hmm, you'll be prepared to walk through it. Mm-hmm. And for me, like, I do remember the last three I made in that game we're talking about. I was doing this, I was having a good time. Literally in my head, right after that possession, I was thinking about that workout in the summer where I didn't want to be there. I could think of 100 million things I could have been doing otherwise, but I showed up there and that kind of kept me on the course.
That's deep. What I love about what you're saying is that this idea of habits and preparation and consistency. Mm-hmm. There's a book James Clear has out. Man, if you haven't read, you got to read it. It's called Atomic Habits. How small habits make big changes. And he talks about this idea that so many people, you know, wonder, okay, when's it going to happen for me? Versus just create a system, mm-hmm, that produces discipline and habits, and your habits will take you everywhere you need to be.
That's beautiful. You know, your habits. That's tough foundation in this generation too, especially when you see, like, from social media perspective and everything, you see the end result. You see a minute clip of me on the court doing all these crazy celebrations.
We don't see the throwing up.
100%.
Don't see the process.
And you don't see how many edits of the trailers you do,
and
all the conversations you have around how breakthrough is supposed to come to life. Mm-hmm. You see the finished product, and so if you can talk about it and understand, like, like the habits and a consistency of your daily efforts that sets you up for that success, you can get there.
I love that. I have a quote that says, "You and I are in control of only two things: how we prepare for what might happen, or how we respond to what just happened. Mm-hmm. When things happen, that's up to God." And so I love what you're saying in that it's about the preparation. You know, put yourself in a position to win, and whatever is up to God, God's going to do it. 100%. Same thing with Joyce. Before Joyce went in that emergency room, she was doing a women's Bible study, mm-hmm, where they were studying Beth Moore's book about believing God. And what does it mean to believe God? What does it mean to take God at his word, that he is who he says he is and will do what he says he can do? So before she got in that emergency room, mm-hmm, she was already practicing breakthrough prayers. Mm-hmm. What role, you've been so vocal about your faith, what role does faith play on a day-to-day basis for you?
Faith gives me the right perspective in terms of I could really tap into what the world says about me, mm-hmm, and what they value as what success means and things like that. And I'm on a continual journey of really understanding how to be a better human being, a better person, no matter how many points I score or whatever the case is. My faith allows me to stay focused on why I'm on this planet to begin with. Because if I were to listen to the noise and to continually feed into what is rewarded in this life, mm-hmm, on earth, mm-hmm, material things or whatever, fame, money, all that type of stuff, like, I would be lost. And I think for me, I understand that I'm on this. I have the skills that I've been given for a reason. I have this platform I have for a reason. And that's to shine light on, you know, who I am playing for on a daily basis. that's not about, I would say that's not about me. It's about what that means in terms of what God's doing in my life through all these different things. And so, again, you know, we all know to whom much is given,
much is required,
but no burden is too tall, too heavy.
Yeah.
And so for me, every day's a challenge in terms of continually to stay focused on things, being fed with the right things, staying in the Word, all those type of vibes. But again, I'm on this stage and this platform and I have these talents for a reason, and I have to shine light on that reason every single day.
Yeah. Totally understand it, man. And you know, it's interesting, you know, being here from the Bay. You know, when I decided, I mean, as a kid, hey, I want to go to entertainment, you know, it wasn't just about going to entertainment, it was about how to do it,
right.
You know. And as a kid, you know, I got baptized when I was, I think, 12 years old. And my intention was like, okay, how do I use faith to go where God wants me to be and do it? But to the point you just made, it's all about perspective.
Mm-hmm.
Because as you're in, you know, whatever profession or living life, it's so easy to get distracted. It's so easy to focus on things that, you know, really aren't the things. So you're right about faith being an anchor and really keeping us where God wants us to be and how he wants us to be. Speaking of which, in terms of how God wants us to be, you know, one of the things that I think is fascinating about the film is, you know, by the time you get to the end of it, you know, everyone says, you know, they're crying all the way through. you know, it's a Kleenex and a popcorn film. So what do you think audiences will take away from this movie?
I think first, no matter kind of where you come from, no matter, you know, what your faith or what your experience in faith is or who you believe in or whatever, there's somebody in this movie that you can relate to. Again, it is an emotional tearjerker. There's something you're gonna be touched. You're gonna be moved by, obviously, John's story in terms of and his comeback and the miracle that takes place. But the depth of how his story affects his community around him, I feel like will resonate in terms of, you know, whatever's going on in your personal life. It might not be as catastrophic as something that, that John's going through, but there's something that can test, that's testing your faith, that this movie will hopefully inspire you to again stay the course, to have that belief, rally around people, you know, that are in your corner. And just believe, man. I think that's the power in the community and power in faith is strong, and it's something that this world needs all through and through.
Right on.
With the chaos that's going on in our world. So
amen.
You'll be moved by this movie. It's gonna be awesome.
Yeah, man. Appreciate you, man.
No problem, DeVon.
Right on. That's right on.